हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज एकी गुप्ता, योर इंग्लिश फैकल्टी, आर्ट्स स्कूल पानसर। सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी नो वेरी वेल दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड फोर पार्ट ऑफ लेसन नंबर फर्स्ट एंड इट्स गोइंग ऑन फिफ्थ पार्ट, वी कैन से इट्स अ लास्ट पार्ट ऑल्सो। सो वी नो वेरी वेल द लेसन नंबर वन, द बेस्ट क्रिसमस प्रेजेंट इन द वर्ल्ड, विच इज रिटन बाय द माइकल मोरप्रोगो। ओके, एंड इट्स अ लास्ट पार्ट, फिफ्थ पार्ट नाउ वी विल फिनिश विद इन few minutes. Okay, so let's start page number 14. Open this page and start. So here I folded the letter again and slipped it carefully back into its envelope. So he was reading a letter, okay, which is written by Jim McPherson. Okay, and so after reading this letter, he folded it and back it is placed into back in the envelope. And thereafter I kept awake all night, means he didn't sleep all night, he awake all night because he was thinking many things, wondering in his mind, okay, what will happen, what had happened that day and what will next. So there was many situation wondering in his mind and he was not sleeping properly. By morning I knew what I had to do, and the next day he knew very well what he is to do. He is to do one thing. I drove into Bridport. So Bridport. I drove into Bridport just a few miles away. Miss Bridport is the address name where Mrs. McPherson lived. Okay. So I asked a boy walking his dog where Copper Beaches was. House number 12 turned out to be nothing but a burned out shell, the roof gaping, the window boarded up. Okay, I knocked at the house next door and asked if anyone knew the whereabouts of Mrs. McPherson. Okay, so exactly he was wandering their side and he saw a boy was there with his dog. So he asked that boy, do you know this address and Copper Beaches and Bridport, in Bridport Copper Beaches house number 12. So he did not give any reply with satisfactory. So that thereafter he watched one thing. There was a burned house, okay, and a roofing gaping, there was no roof, gaping was there, and blocked window means totally we can say in the simple language the house has been destroyed. Okay, so he think, let's ask to another person next door. When he reached the next door, there was, oh yes, said the old man in his sleeper. Once there was an old man and he was in sleeper and he told, oh yes, I know that, I know her. He knew her well, a lovely old lady, he told me, a bit muddled-headed. Muddled-headed means some little bit confused. Okay, means like this, oh, that lady, I know, means that is, he was something confused, but he told about her lady, means that is so beautiful lady, and he was telling about that lady to Mr. Writer. And what he told? He told, a lovely old lady, he told me, a bit muddle-headed, but at her age she was entitled to be, wasn't she? Means entitled means like to be same, okay, and entitled means to compliment, to give compliment. She is looking like, because she is beautiful, so I can say she is a beautiful old lady, okay, and he is asking, wasn't she? Means the old man is asking to writer, you don't know, she is not beautiful, she is beautiful, old lady, but she is beautiful. 101 year old, she is 101 year old, okay. She had been in the house when it caught fire. No one really knew how the fire had started, but it could well have been candles. She used candles rather than electricity. Means exactly nobody knows that how the house had got fire, but there is a exceptional case that she was using candles because she thought candle is good. good rather than electricity, because if I will use electricity, so I will have to pay some extra charges for that. If I will use kindles, so it will be enough for me. Okay. And thereafter, the fireman had to got her out just in time. She was in a nursing home now. He told me Burlington House on the Dorchester Road on the other side of town. So that old man told her that she was safely saved from that house, and she was shifted to nursing home. That is Burlington. That is the Burlington House and Dorchester Road. And finally, the writer found that address, and what was there? Burlington House Nursing Home, easily enough, and there were paper chains up in the hallway, and a lighted Christmas tree stood in the corner with a lopsided angle on top. So lopsided means there is another place in the corner side where is a blank, and you have used this place for using anything like Christmas tree, like any thing you have used there to be show off that it's looking so beautiful and nice. Okay. Thereafter, I said I was a friend come to visit Mrs. MacPherson and to bring her a Christmas present. So a writer went to reception and told her that I am a writer, and I want to meet Mrs. MacPherson. I have a best Christmas present for her. If you want to miss, if you would like to meet me to her, so I can give her. I could see through into the dining room where everyone was wearing a paper hat and singing. The matron had a hat on too and seemed happy enough to see me. Okay, so exactly I have been sent for the hall, and there was a lot of people. They were playing, they were enjoying, and everyone has worn a paper hat, which is made by the paper, like a simple paper, okay, or colorful paper. It may be colorful paper, it may be made. Okay, so everyone enjoying and everyone laughing there. That's celebrating the Christmas tree, Christmas present. And thereafter, but see, she even offered me my spy. So it is an eatable item, which is eaten in any party. Okay, so that is my spy. She walked me along the corridor, and Mrs. MacPherson is not in with the other. She told me she is rather confused today, so we thought it best if she had a good rest. She has no family, you know, no one visits, so I am sure she will be only too pleased to see you. Here is a reception who is telling to Mr. Writer that one thing. Exactly, Mrs. MacPherson has no any relationship and no any person to know. Okay, she has forgotten everyone in her relationship. She knows only about her husband, but her husband didn't meet till now, and it has been long years. Okay, so now at the time she is not recognizing to anyone, but we thought if she will meet you and she would meet you, so definitely she will feel happy. So because of this, we called her and wait here. She is coming here. Okay. After some time, she took me into a conservatory with a wicker chair and potted plants all around and left me. Means both are at the place where a conservatory means a totally a congested area, means a crowded area with the plants, not the person. Okay, with the plants and some articles, items. Okay, there was nothing any other thing which is not like. Okay, so everything was there, and both were alone there. The old lady was sitting in a wheelchair because she was 101 year old. She was not able to walk, so she was sitting on the wheelchair. Her hands folded in her lap means like this type. Okay, you can understand. And thereafter, she had a silver white hair pinned into a wispy bun. Wispy bun means, like you can understand, like a round hair upside. Okay. It looks like a ball, okay? And it is silver white hair. Silver white hair, why means? Why? Because this used word, because it's looking like a little bit white, okay? And next, she was gazing out at the garden. Garden means which is where you have seen the there are lots of plants. So she was wandering here and there, and she was gazing at all these things. And hello, I said. She turned and looked up at me vacantly. Happy Christmas, Connie, I went on. I found this. I think it's yours. As I was speaking, her eyes never left my face. I opened the tin box and gave it to her. Writer said, hello, Connie. This is your present for the Christmas present. And this is, I think this is the best present for the work. For you in the world, if you will accept this. And that was a letter which has been read and which has been written by the Mr. MacPherson. So when she was taking letter, that time she was gazing at his face while getting the letter, okay? And Connie was surprised. Exactly, Connie was surprised that a person has come to meet me, and that she was so surprised. Means it has been long year anyone came to meet me. Okay, so you can understand this thing. I opened the tin box and gave to her. That was the moment her eyes lit up. Lit up means light, means us shining in her eyes with recognition, and her face becomes first with a sudden glow of happiness. Means when she got letter, that time she was happy and some smiling face, and she got shining on her face. I explained about the desk, okay, about how I had found it, but I don't think she was listening for a while. So that time a writer told all these things, what happened, how he got this letter, and how he got that roll top desk also, and the whole story will be described to before that lady, okay? But he thought one thing, that she is not listening properly all these things. She said nothing. She says nothing, but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. Okay, she used her fingertips, and she opened the letter, and she was lying her fingers on the letter like this. Okay, you can see this. Okay. Thereafter, suddenly she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. So she took my hand. She took my hand, and there was tear in her eyes. You told me you would come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. She said that you told me that you will come on Christmas, and I was waiting for you. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim, dear, sit down. So, definitely you said and you did. You said and you did. You came on the Christmas day, and it is the biggest, it is a great present for me in the world. When you came today, sit down please near. I sat down beside her and she kissed me cheek. Means I sit down beside her and she kissed me on my cheek. Okay. And read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. Means, how many letters you have written to me? All letters I have read, and I felt this thing, that you are always with me. You are always with me. Okay, my dear students. And now you are back. You can read it to me yourself. Would you do that for me, Jim dear? I just want to hear your voice again. I would love that so much. And then perhaps we will have some tea. I have made you a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. So she told. Please. See exactly you. Got one thing, that Mrs. MacPherson, that old lady, was thinking that is not a writer, that is a Jim MacPherson. She was thinking he is my husband. She is not thinking that another person, that is a writer. She is thinking that is my husband and he is Jim MacPherson. So she is telling, please read this letter and I want to listen your voice because it has been long time to listen you. Okay. And because I am not able to see properly to you, but and I am not able to see properly to you, and I am not able to read this letter also. So please, you read out, and I want to listen your voice also. At last, when you will finish this letter, so I will make. I have made for you a mercy pancake, and I will give you. I know very well how much you love mercy pancake. So my dear students, here the story ends. Okay, and the story has been completed. This chapter's question answer will be sent soon. And till when, wait for the question answer. There's a PDF file, that will be PDF file. And my dear students, please stay home, be safe home, at home, and keep studying, keep doing all these things, whatever have been taught to you all of you. Okay, so thank you.